What audit test in our audit class. In this chapter, we are going to talk about that link audit objective to management assertion. We are classifying, defining and applying the audit test. So this is a very important chapter also, because as an auditor in our audit works, which type of test they will, what kind of test that we are going to apply. The financial statements, of course, financial statements must be prepared by the company management. So this is their responsibilities, and they will prepare it. They will submit to the auditor for audited. The financial statements contain the management assertion, which they will apply generally accepted accounting principles and the international financial reporting standards. This is our criteria. Management assertions are claims made by the members of the management regarding certain aspect of a business. Validity of the management assertions, it also our audit test. So the management assertions lead to the audit objectives. They become audit objectives, and these in a detailed way we talk about that in chapter 3. So what are these? What is the steps of the audit objectives? First of all, understand objectives and responsibilities. And we divided financial statements into cycles, and we know the management assertions, and we know the general audit objectives, and also we know that the specific audit objectives. First of all, the management assertions and audit objectives, how they match it, what kind of relation they have. Let's talk about the management assertion first. Is a presentation, occurrence, existence, classifications, cutoff, accuracy, valuation and allocation, valuations, right and obligations, and completeness. These are 10 of them are management assertions that they will become a audit objectives for us. For the management assertions, of course, management assertions about transaction and events and the related disclosure, occurrence, completeness, accuracy, cutoff, classification, and presentations. After that, we have the management assertions about account balances and related disclosure, existence, rights and obligations, completeness, accuracy, valuation and allocations, classification, and presentations. I'm just talking about the concepts and concepts. There is a definition and explanations in your chapter that you can get it from. Here, I'm just giving a concept. So, in a detailed way, you can learn from your book. All these detailed information exist in the chapter. Please go and read the chapters. Management assertion for each category of the assertions is like the transaction, for the events, and for the account balances. For the transaction and events, you can see from the chapter, occurrence, completeness, accuracy, cutoff, classification, and presentation for the transaction and events. For the account balances, we are concentrated for the assertions, existence, rights and obligation, completeness, accuracy, valuation, completeness, accuracy, valuation and allocation, classification and presentation. When we divided the management assertion for each categories, for the transaction and events has a different one, for the account balances has a different one. This is important. Why? Because these management assertions become an audit objective for us. Therefore, as an auditor, we must really understand which audit objectives. I'm going to apply for the account balances, for the transaction and the events. For the transaction related audit objectives, for general transaction related audit objectives, there are six of them: occurrence, completeness, accuracy, posting and summarization, classification and timing. After that, of course, this general audit objective related with the transaction issue, they become a specific transactions related audit objectives. So for the balance related audit objectives, in a general way, general audit as a general audit objectives, existence, completeness, accuracy, classification, cutoff, detail, tie-in, realizable value, rights and obligation. Also, according to accounts, these general balance related audit objectives become specific balance related audit objectives. But it's not these general audit objective cannot be exist for every balances, every accounts. You have to be pick some of them according to characterization of the accounts, so they become a specific balance related audit objectives. Audit test. What does it mean? The purpose of audit test or audit procedure is to allow the auditor to collect sufficient appropriate audit evidence to be able to conclude with reasonable assurance that the financial statements are free of the material misstatements. So this is the main purpose of the audit test or the audit procedure. Some books call as an audit procedure, some books call as an audit test. I prefer audit test, but I use both of them because if you are using some other books that you can, if you read audit procedure, that will be, it is the same meaning. So the phase of a financial statements audit, there are four phase. One is plan and designing an audit approach based on risk assessment procedure. There are four phase of a financial statements audit. The first one is plan and design an audit approach based on risk assessment procedure. The second one is perform test of controls and substantive test of transactions. Perform analytical procedure and test of the details of balances and complete the audit and issue an audit reports. What is the type of the audit test? Audit test, there is risk assessment procedure, test of controls, substantive test of transaction, substantive analytical procedure, test of details of balances. There are five main audit tests that we are talking about in this chapter. Risk assessment procedures. It is an audit procedure to assess the risk that material misstatement exists. Of course, in that risk assessment procedure, I need to know that audit risk formula. The audit risk formula, that inherent risk multiply control risk multiply deduction risk. So in this audit risk model, inherent risk and the control risk, risk in this model, inherent risk and control risk comes from the client firm. Deduction risk is comes from the auditors. Therefore, these three type of the risk come together and we calculate audit risk with this formula. Test of the controls. Let's start to talk about the test of the controls. Just remember that we are focusing on internal control system of the company. We are measuring control risk level, and according to this control risk level, we are applying test of controls or not. So let's see what is the test of the controls. Test of the controls, audit procedure to test the effectiveness of the controls in support of a reduced assessing control risk. So in that case, in the planning stage, we measure the control risk level. If it's a low level or if it's a acceptable level, which means we are starting test of the control. It means we are applying test of the controls because Test of the controls reduce the assessed control risk. Make inquiries and appropriate client business personal. This is one of the test of the control. We are examine documents, records and reports. We are observe implementation of the control related activities. Re-perform implementation of control procedure by the auditors. There are four main tests of the controls that we are applying. After that, we will aim that we are reducing assessing control risk. Substantive test of the transaction. It is after understanding the internal control. We are assessing planning the control risk and we are determining the extent of the test of the controls. After the test of the controls, we are designing test of the controls and substantive test of transaction to meet transaction related audit objectives. So audit procedure, sample size, items to select and timing, it is the most important items for the designing of the substantive test of the transaction. I will explain something to here. Test of the controls is the interim test, which we are applying the test of the controls during the term, during the audit term. But the substantive test of the transaction, we are doing the at the end of the year, which I audited. This is my audit terms. At the end of the term, which is December 31st, I'm applying the substantive test of the transaction. So this is one test groups is applying by the auditors in the middle of the term. One type of the audit test will applying at the end of the term. So they are supporting each other, but also test of the controls and the structure of the internal control system and the control risk level will help me to design the substantive test of the transaction. So they are really affecting each other. Another one is substantive analytical procedures. Analytical procedures, of course, we are using financial and non-financial data and analyzing the client firm situation. So in the analytical procedure or analytical review procedure, use the comparisons and relationship to assess whether account balances or other data appear reasonable. Then we indicate the possible misstatements in the financial statements and we provide the substantive evidences. Therefore, we call it as a substantive analytical procedure. Test of details of balances. Test of details of balances are specified procedure intended to test for monetary misstatements in the balances in the financial statements. We are identifying and assessing risk of the material misstatements, set performance materiality, assess control risk, design and perform test, design and perform analytical procedure, designing test of the details of accounts. These are the steps that we are following under the test of the details of balances. Test of the details of balances is the ending term test, which is done by the auditors. So we are just getting all the evidences from the financial statements. Therefore, test of the details of balances is the ending balance of the accounts that auditor concentrated and collecting all the evidences with this test. Type of the test in order of increasing cost. There is of course, I need to calculate the cost of this test. I cannot apply the high cost. I cannot. During the audit works, I have to calculate the cost of this test, which type of the test will be more costly or not. So how am I gonna do this? Which one is okay? Audit test. Now I'm going to calculate the cost issue for the taste side. In this slide, I'm going to talk about the type of the test in order of increasing cost. Increasing of the cost means substantive analytical procedure, risk assessment procedure, test of controls, substantive test of transactions, test of details of balances. These are the increasing the cost of the test. Therefore, I'm going to, as an auditor, I'm going to calculate the cost. I must make the cost and benefit analysis, and I need to accumulate the evidences, not high costly, but the evidences will gonna be really effective for me. So these are the tests that I will apply during the, my audit works. So we now I finish chapter 5. I will continue with the chapter 6.